Hello, Jemalf here, and welcome back to Let's Play Dark Souls. This is the part 2 of the Let's Play, and in this one I will run around getting some items around this area and other areas I have access to because I have the master key. One of the great things about Dark Souls is that it is very open in what you can do. There are very few things you actually need to do. I'll talk to you later. Very few things you actually need to do, and you can choose the path you take quite freely. And I will use that to my advantage, that I can go to places and can gather items just because I know where they are, and get some items that I will use later on. And some items I really don't need, but I will just collect them because I happen to be here. I will first get some items from the graveyard. I will also go to a new Londo, get a Firekeeper soul from there, and I will do a run to Blighttown, the Valley of Drakes, possibly even Darkroot Garden, but we'll see about that. Alright, I have no intention of fighting anything. I will just collect everything I can find. Well, mainly this weapon here, which I plan to use later. And I think there was something here. Binoculars. Ooh, almost died. Okay, now I can die. Bye-bye. That was first of many deaths, I'm sure. There are still some items there in the graveyard I can take. Yeah, this game is, well, quite literally, dead is dead. Okay, there was the soul there, and then there was the shield I can take. Don't necessarily need it, but I will go and get it. Oh, hello. I didn't remember I wake you up this soon. Oh, I went the wrong way. Damn it. Okay, well, then we'll wake everyone up. Missed me. There it was. Okay, I think that's all the items in the graveyard. I could just kill myself here, but I think I can also rest at the bonfire to reset them. Although it would have been faster to actually just kill myself, but this'll do. So I got some items from there, and it's actually faster if I just get all my items off. Doing what I'm doing here, this is well, like pretty much everything in this game, as I said, is optional. But since I have played the game, I want to get myself a good start and get some items and weapons, armor, that I will use pretty much throughout the game after getting them here at the beginning. Not sure about S-Dog. I do like this sword, but not sure yet if I will use it much. The Swyhander I might... Oh, actually probably will use. I like it. It's a nice great sword. And the armor I get from Blighttown will probably serve me well for quite some time. And the items I can get from Valley of Drakes, the sword, goes well with my cleric and the fate build. The Astora sword, scaling with fate, good starter weapon for me. That was the thing I was looking for, so I can die. If I make the run to Dark Root Garden as well, I can get the Elite Knight's armor from there. If I choose to go with heavy armor, I will probably use that one for quite some time. I used Firekeeper's Soul to reinforce my Estus Flask, so now the Estus Flask is plus one power, healing me more when I use it. This video, this part 2 is probably an exception in this Let's Play. This is probably the only one where I run around looking for items like I do here. And later on I might do some farming souls or farming items. I will show what I'm doing, but I will skip the repetitive parts. Showing what I do, but then skip the 15 minutes or 5 hours of farming I might do. This door here I can open because I took the master key, and that's literally the key in getting many of these items I'm getting. So let's go to Blight Town first. Because here I will most likely die. The hardest part of this this suicide running I'm doing. It's quite easy to actually get killed by these guys if they hit me. Especially when going without an armor. Well, I made through them. I don't remember if I need this key or not. I will take it. It's actually quite surprising how well I remember this, even though it's been many, many months since I played the Xbox version. But I guess I started new games so often that I learned this route quite well. Fuck! Close. Really close. Too close, in fact. Okay, let's try to stay on the tree here. I remember this guy was tricky to bypass. Ooh, I actually made it. Nice. Very nice. This was the one I was looking for, and the good thing about this is that actually it's... Oh! I was pretty sure you'd be dead. Alright, let me homeward bone away from here. Yes, go. Ooh, that was close. Actually now that I think of it, I might have just killed myself. I don't think I can level up with 700 souls. Yeah. Oh well. Wasted the homeward bone there, but doesn't really matter. Even that I didn't hit anyone, I got some of those enemies killed because they dropped from those high structures in Blight Town. Next, Valley of Drakes again. But this time I'll actually go deeper into it. I will get the sword I will very likely be using for quite some time. I think it was some sword of Astora. Astora's sword. And if I don't die, I will run through as well to get the ring that gives me bonus when I'm low on health, and then I will probably die already, and I need to run back, and I will go through the Darkroot Basin and Darkroot Garden to get some items. I don't know why I'm keeping these weapons and weapons and shield out, because I'm not really hitting anything. Well, actually, the shield will come useful, especially if I take that one. Well, actually, they have the same lightning reduction, which I will need soon. This zombie dragon will attack me. But I can get some items from it without waking it up. Now, which one of these was the sword? That one. And that one is the shield. Go, 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 go! Ooh! Luckily, that dragon just stays still and doesn't go anywhere. I was actually quite surprised from that I managed to take both of them without getting hit. Alright, I remember these guys are tricky. That went well. Get him, get him. Oh wow. I should record Dark Souls. I should have recorded Dark Souls way before. I don't think I've ever made it here on the first go when I started a new game. No, I did. And I think, at least in theory, it's possible for me to get away from here alive. It's a bit tricky, but... Well, no. If I had hit the ground, I could have rolled and then get away from those lightnings, but... not the case there. That would have saved me this run I need to do now when I go to a... go through to the... Dark Roots Basin and Garden. And it's so easy to forget that the elevator is down when you have used it once. I'm sure quite many Dark Souls players have run here and straight into that pit and die. When they have done something similar I'm doing here. Or farming something down here. Right, I got the sword, so I guess I might as well start using that one now. Astora's straight sword, it was. If you see me rolling like that when I drop, that's because it's faster. I don't have to take such a long time after dropping, and I also take less damage from the fall. That was the idea also, dropping from that very high tower I was in. I could have survived the drop by rolling. Or actually, maybe I should have worn armor, I don't know. Right, but this guy is now awake, and I need to avoid this poison cloud. Not too difficult, but need to do it. And I need to stay away from that claw attack. That was actually close. Too close. I thought he would just breathe poison. Nearly got myself killed. Yeah, if you play the game yourself and you try this, the key here is to run against them when they start their attack. Move to left or right to dodge the attack, so they don't move after they have started to breathe attack. So running kind of sideways always saves you. And this is where I was going, and the elevator is here. Good. In here, I do need to make a choice. Do I take a risk and not rest at this bonfire here? Which means if I die in the forest, I will need to go and make that run again. I will put this armor on. If I rest here and I die in the forest, I will return here. But then again, if I don't die, I can use the homeward bone to get all the way back to Firelink Shrine, so I think I will take my chances. And now that I did this, I'm sure I will die to this Black Knight right here. Or roll over the edge. Ooh, that was close. Run away, run away, run away, run away, run away. Was the hunter armor? Are you still following me? No. Was the hunter armor here? No. That's not the spot. It's above. And the knight is not following me. Good. That was the part I was afraid of, but I think I can survive the rest of the forest now. Yeah, this was the hunter set. The reason I remember this as well as I do is because I have watched other people's Let's Plays and some other Dark Souls videos as well. So even that it's been quite some time, almost a year, at least 9 months since I've played, I still remember this quite well. These areas. Oh, hey, you I need to kill. Come on. Oh, didn't get a chunk or slap. Alright, let's try to get through the living trees without dying. And then if I get all the way to the Elite Knight armor, my mission is done. Hello? Remember there were some souls here being that I could pick up, but I think I need to keep running. There was one. Those trees are surprisingly fast. There's a hidden bonfire there, but I won't go to it because I don't really need to. I will go here, however. There is the armor set I came to look for. In an ambush. Yes, nice. Perfect. Now I can die. Now I can die or collect some more items. But I don't really remember anymore if there was any items in here. There was a hidden wall here somewhere. I remember where it was. And those guys are after me, so I can't really stop and look too much. Right, here was an ambush. I might as well take this ambush now. Running away, running away. I could go all the way and bypass quite a lot of the game by going into the church right away. I won't do that, but I could. I don't recall how I could get that one. Maybe I need to drop from above. Ooh, almost ran into my doom. I'm really not sure what I'm doing in here. I'm checking, was there any other items in here or not? Guess not. didn't say what you were there. I guess I could try to get some items from the basin. Because now if I die it doesn't really matter, I got the items I really wanted. Already. Interesting that the lizard corpse is still there. Alright, I didn't die. That's why. Yeah, the only thing I'm doing now is just coming in here, seeing if I can get some items from the... some items from here before I die. As said, if I die, that's fine. I don't really remember, was there many items in here? There's some items in there, but there are also some extremely dangerous enemies in here. And of course the Hydra. Oh, hello, Golem. Missed me. What was this? Oh, knight's armor. Nice. Okay, good. Oh, I think I'm dead. Oh. Alright, I can't. Can't run much in this water. Hydra will hit me with its water attacks. I could go somewhere from there. Was there something here? I honestly don't remember. I will come into these areas later on to actually fight. Yeah, nothing here. Oh no. I keep moving, he's not hitting me. Ooh, that was close. I don't remember where this ladder takes me. And will I die from the Hydra's attacks while I climb? Well, at least not there. There's still time. He's trying. Oh, I actually got some souls. Where did those come from? I remember this ladder being mostly for getting down from here, but I guess it works that way as well. You can't touch me here, can you? Alright, was there something here? Well, there is something. Ah, oh, more souls. This will help me level up when I do go back. What was here? I planned to get that elite knight armor. I didn't plan this one, and these are actually areas I haven't been in that often. Dark Root Garden. All right. See if I can see any items I could run to before I die. There's probably more of those trees here. I see something there that I can probably pick up. So let's try to run there before I die. Yeah, some trees are already after me. Oh shit, there's a lot of them. Shit! Ooh, go, 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 go. Get that. Yes. Booyah. All the trees jumped behind me. Oh wow, that was exciting. I actually found many items I haven't even seen in the game before. What was that? So I have knight armor, I have the eastern armor. Alright, let's see how those are. So they are relatively heavy armors. All of them. I can try them on just to see how they look like. Eastern armor. Oh, nice. Oh, that is cool. The normal knight armor. I think the elite knight's armor is the one I will actually use when I have the endurance for it. I think the guy at the asylum is actually wearing this one. But for now, I really don't have the endurance for anything else but this one. Although, don't remember how. Yeah, I think I will keep the brigand armor for now. What I will do, however, is use all those souls I found and get some leveling up from these. Not too much, but might as well because I got all these. So let's get some souls. These ones I will use. 1,000 a pop. Actually, no, I won't use them all just yet. They are like souls I can have what in whatever point I want. But I wanted couple of level ups here. Oh, I need one more. All right, I want my strength to be 16. I guess I can get that later on. I'll get some souls when I go through Undead Burg. Right, this concludes the part two of this Let's Play, and I will from here, I guess, follow the more traditional path. I will go through Undead Burg and go towards the church, the first bell, and work from there. And I just wanted to do that those items runs here at the beginning, and now I have those items I want, the elite knight armor, the Zweihänder. I will get Claymore later on, the halberd, and work from there. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this one. If you took this as some sort of a guide in getting items, I hope you found this useful. And I hope to see you in the part 3 when this Let's Play continues, and we will actually go and do something else than just running around and doing suicide runs. Right, until then, take care. Bye bye.